Hello, I'm Mike. I'm going to show you the website that codes itself. Every single square you see here was designed by someone using natural language and then deployed by an AI agent that wrote the code, just from a simple comment. And today I'm going to show you how Zapier's brand new integration with Cursor lets you build a self-updating and collaborative website. Now, maybe you remember the $1 million homepage where people could submit a dollar and then buy a pixel on a website. This idea is very similar. First, I'm going to put a prompt in here, a very simple prompt to create index and style CSS. It will be a standard HTML5 boilerplate and essentially a vibe-coded page with pixels that can be customized. It doesn't take long before it's created the index page, and it's working on creating the styles as well. Okay, that's all done. It was really simple. It took just seconds. It's a simple website. Now we can take a look at it. There you go. I just loaded this page, vibe coded. Every vibe on this wall was coded by an AI agent triggered by a public social media comment. Now you'll notice I've used this creator-magic.github.io because I'm going to use GitHub Pages to host this page. First, we've initialized the repository and I'll type in first commit. And as you can see, I've run a few commands here and it should be initialized here in the Creator Magic organization. Indeed it is. But the best thing about creating a repo like this one, I can go to the pages setting here, say deploy from a branch, which is what we want. And of course, choose the main branch of this new Git repo we made with Cursor. That's all done, and you can see now it's pending. It's just doing some checks here. Yes, GitHub is actually running its own way of building my site. Then it's going to check it out and upload it so that I'll be able to access this page on the web. Okay, we're green. Let's go. And boom, vibe-coded page is now live. This is where we can have some fun on automation. I'll head over to Zapier and create a brand new Zap. We'll call this one Vibe Agent Create. We'll just start off with the trigger as a schedule that runs every day at midnight to start with. Okay, with that done, this is where the fun starts. Cursor. If I type that in, you'll now see that Cursor is indeed an integration inside Zapier. And for the first action event, we are going to say launch an agent. This is really exciting. You'll see that I've already created and linked my Cursor account, but if you haven't, it's just going to ask you to find your API key in your Cursor dashboard under background agents, and it links you to exactly where you need to go. If you haven't done that already, you'll see here in Cursor under background agents, there's the ability to create an API key right here. With that done, you should be all connected up and you can go to the next step. This is where the fun starts because you can put in your prompt to your Cursor coding AI agent. Now for the prompt, I'll make it quite detailed so the agent does exactly what I want. You're a surgical AI web developer and you're to add one vibe square to a collaborative project. Okay, it's going to be index and a vibe grid there, and you'll update the style CSS. And then we've got the user's name, which I'll map later when I change the trigger for this, and also a vibe description so I can copy whatever I like. In this case, I'm going to say a glowing pulsing white circle on a dark purple background. Next, we're going to grab the URL of this repository and we're going to paste it in here as the repository URL. It is indeed the main branch we're working with. Everything else can be left as is. If we like, we can actually choose the AI model that's used by our Cursor agent to do the coding. With this all done, we'll click continue. And now we've gone ahead and created that request. It's creating a status of an agent working on this particular repo. It's even making its own branch name and everything else is provided. This is a really good start. Now, if we go to cursor.com/agents, you will see that there's an agent. It's actually in action writing Mike Russell's vibe. This is so very cool. You can see everything is happening right here. And very soon it's going to give me the ability to merge this in via a pull request. Okay, perfect. It's completed. It's summarizing this. This is all happening in the cloud. And it was indeed triggered by my Zapier Zap that I made just a moment ago. All right, so we're ready to create that pull request, but we don't want to do it manually. We want to totally automate this process. This time I'm creating a new Zap and this will be called Vibe Agent Publish. Now, as our trigger, we'll again use Cursor, and you can use Cursor as a trigger. In this case, it will poll an agent for a status change. What we're interested in is when the agent finishes its job. So we'll continue onwards and we'll test this trigger. And indeed, look at this, it's found that my agent has finished its job on my Creator Magic repo. This is absolutely fantastic. It even summarizes what has been done so we can continue on and make this work further. And we're going to connect to GitHub this time. Now we'll scroll down the action events and you'll see there's create a pull request. This is what we need. Let's continue. We'll make sure to select the correct repo here to start with, and then for our title here, well, we can pull this in from our cursor agent. Add new user vibe square will be the title. And for the body, you guessed it, we can map that in from our cursor agent. Of course, when it finished up, it gave us a beautiful summary of what it's done, so we'll simply pop that in. Now, it's very important for the head that we actually change to a custom value, which we can map in. And you'll see here from the cursor agent, again, we've got the branch that we want to make sure we merge in. With that done, we'll merge it to the base, which is main in this instance, and we'll call it an insta-merge, which will mean it will merge immediately. Before we proceed any further, let me just show you this repo and show you that, as you can see, our cursor agent made a new branch, but there's no pull request just yet. Nothing is happening here right now. Let's go back and continue with this automation, and we'll go ahead and test this step. Success, it all worked. It gives me some feedback here, which is exactly what I want to see. Over here in GitHub, we'll refresh this. And now we can see there's one closed pull request. Yes, it's been successfully merged, a new user vibe square. Now, immediately, if I go back to the code, you'll see here a yellow dot indicating that, again, GitHub is redeploying my GitHub page. And you can see it's pretty much getting there. And the deploy should now turn green, which it did. This is really exciting. We're going to see my agent's vibe-coded square on my GitHub deployed page. All of this done with Zapier. Refresh. Oh my goodness, look at this. There is an animated glowing circle on a purple background on my vibe code page. And this was all done with AI agents orchestrated by the largest AI orchestration platform out there, Zapier. If you like what you see so far, throw a like and subscribe. I do tutorials like this weekly. And this was all done with two simple zaps, one that launches a cursor agent, the next one that waits for the agent to complete, and then automatically merges it so it's deployed to my website. This is a totally autonomous process and one of the wildest automations I've built so far. Now I'm just going to neaten this up. We'll add a filter in here and we'll say only continue if the source repository exactly matches the repository we want to alter. Let's continue. And you can see the zap would have continued here. But if I'm working on any other GitHub projects, this will not continue. Let's publish that zap and test it one more time. Okay, back over in my vibe agent create, we'll just go ahead and change this to something different, a spinning square with a rainbow gradient border. We'll continue with that, and again, we'll retest this step, so it should call a cursor agent to alter my page deployed on GitHub. And you can see it's creating right now. If we actually go over to, yes, you can see, here it is. It's spinning up as a background agent. It's creating a vibe square with Mike Russell with a spinning rainbow gradient border this time. Okay, it says it's done it all. Look at this, my agent is wrapping up. And the best thing is my autonomous zap will pick up this pull request, merge it automatically, and it'll be insta-deployed to my GitHub page. All right, let's refresh this page, and wow, look at this. I've got a spinning rainbow quadrant square. Mike Russell's vibe, two vibes going on here. This is cool. And if we look over here in my cursor project, we can see that these branches are getting merged in automatically, and I can pull down the updates and have a look at all the changes. Mike Russell's vibe has been added twice here to the vibe grid, and the styles have been updated here at the bottom with all of my different rainbow vibes and pulsing glowing white circle vibes as well. Let's just try one more time, a background that slowly shimmers from black to dark blue. Let's go ahead and refresh, and here we go. We've got another background border that is going between different colors. This could get pretty interesting pretty fast, so that's why I'm going to hand it over to you. Yes, I'm going to give you full control of my cursor agent by going to the trigger here, and instead of using a schedule, I'm actually going to use my community. That's where, if you're a member of my community, you'll be able to make your own vibe square. So we'll use Circle, which is the community I host on. As a trigger event, we'll search for new comment posted. Now we'll configure, we'll choose community creator magic, space will be discussion, AI agents, turn your comments into code. So I've said I've connected an AI coder to the post. You need to describe your vibe with a reply. A cursor AI agent will instantly write the code. Zapier and GitHub will auto deploy it to this website here. And it's 100% automated. I'll just go ahead and type in a triangle that gently bounces up and down. And indeed, my cursor agent has picked this up perfectly, and it's working on the bouncing triangle animation. I can't wait to see what's going to appear here. Well, it seems the task is wrapping up here. Now let's refresh. Oh look, we've got a bouncing triangle. Kind of reminds me of Vercel a little bit. If I click it, boom, it's going to take me straight to the comment that generated that vibe. And just like that, we go from a simple text comment to a live coded animation on a website with zero manual work. Zapier, Cursor, Agents, absolutely phenomenal. The entire loop from idea to deployment was 100% automated. And now I want you to try it. I'm leaving this live for everyone to play with. The link to the post that you need to comment on is in the description. You can go ahead and comment and leave your own vibe up on the wall and watch it appear just a few minutes later. What would you do with AI that can actually write and deploy code on command? Let me know some of your craziest ideas down in the comments. And if you thought it was really cool, make sure you subscribe, throw a like and all that good stuff. Thank you so much for watching. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.